What's up again, everybody? Today we're going to talk about Ice Control Blitz Oldham. And the reason we're talking about this is because Flesh and Blood has celebrated its 2-year anniversary. And in doing so, we, as a couple of my friends, I should say, I'll be very specific, Red Zone Rogue, Ian from Right Time Gaming and Radio Reflex, and Jim from Fab TCG Cards LLC, we're going to get together, we're going to play a UPF game where each of us got one set to build from, and we opened one box from that set, and we can only use cards that we opened in that box. So I'm pretty sure Ian got Welcome to Wraith, and he's going to build most likely a Brute. Let's be honest, Ian is like all about Brute, but he could play anything. He's been in the game since the beginning, used to work at LSS. We know that Red Zone Rogue is going to play Viscerai. In fact, you can actually watch his video. Link in the description. Check out his box opening and video. So that's pretty exciting. I don't know what Jim is going to play. He's got access to Monarch, but I'm not quite sure what he's going to run. So that's going to be interesting. And I opened perhaps like the most destined to be Oldham deck in a box that I have ever seen in my life. So I, of course, had to oblige the Winter's Whale pull, and I built Ice Oldham. So Ice Oldham is, Oldham, I should say. Oldham is pretty cool in that he is a new hero from this new Tales of Aria set as I focus him up. And he has this ability that says, if you, as a defense reaction, if you pitch 3, and you pitch an Earth card, then you can prevent 2 damage. But if you pitch an Ice card, you force the player that's attacking you to put a card from their hand on top of their deck. And that's really spicy if you want to play nice and slow and controlly. And we lucked into pulling exactly what we'd want to do that with, which is Winter's Whale. Once per turn action, pitch 3 to attack for 4, which is great. That's a solid little break point with a weapon. And it says if you pitch an ice card this way to trigger this effect, then it gains, if it hits a hero, create a frostbite token under their control. So in other words, if this Winter's Whale ends up hitting your opponent after you've pitched away like a blue ice card, for example, they're going to get a frostbite. And if you don't know frostbites, they're pretty sweet. I was just making some earlier this evening at a draft. Frostbites are pretty fun. They make your opponent pay an extra resource to do stuff. So because we pulled Winter's Whale, I really wanted to lean into it and build Ice Oldham. So that's what I did. Before we get into the deck itself, I do have a Rotten Old Buckler, which is very cool. I don't have this in cold foil, otherwise I would have swapped it out for a cold foil version. The equipment very quickly is Plume of Evergrowth, which is cool because you can go and fetch an Earth card. We don't have a ton of them, but it's useful perhaps, I don't know. Cracker Jacks is fantastic because we're going to pop it off onto a thump that we have several in the deck of. Runaways is good if we're trying to deal with Rune Chance because we can do that in this set. By the way, also, we can choose to swap out Cracker Jacks if we want, and we can play Arcane Barrier because that was one of the rules we gave each other, a house rule. Everyone gets one piece of Arcane Barrier equipment. And then we did pull a cold foil in the box. It was a Coat of Frost, and so I said, why not just let it fly? Let's run the Coat of Frost cold foil just for giggles. So that's the equipment, that's the weapon. Now let's talk about the Elemental Guardian attacks that we have access to. We pulled an Endless Winter, which is a fantastic card. It's one that we want to be fusing and one that we want to be threatening someone with. It cost 4, so we do have to kind of pitch a lot for it. You know, it's not too terribly bad. It is 4, it's not like 8 or something like that. Even if it you do just pitch it and you don't fuse it, it still attacks for 8, which is pretty beefy when everyone has 20 health. We also have Oaken Old, which is Earth and Ice Fusion. This card, probably not gonna get fused in this game. I don't see myself fusing it unless I land the other Majestic that fuses this very easily, but it's still a nice little attack. These double Snow Unders are fantastic. This card is one of my favorites in the set for Oldham. Snow Under just feels really good to play, and then it feels even better to play and fuse, threatening a Frostbite. We have 2 blues as well to kind of help in pitching. By the way, I just want to say 22 cards in our 40-card Blitz deck are blue. 22 of them, so we're going to have a lot of blue access, which is good because if we have to defend with a lot, we can then still come in with like a blue. Glacial Footsteps is pretty good. It's a good little finisher. You can pitch it away early. And I did decide to play 2 Emerging Avalanches because we can fuse them very easily in this deck. And so we can play this down and show an ice card and then just jam some frostbites on people. And I'm playing 1 copy of Red Biting Gale. I don't know if I will play this card. I may switch it before, but I thought, you know what? It blocks for four. It seems kind of fun as a defense reaction. I kind of hate Biting Gale because it costs so much, but if I can, you know, pitch this and then show for Fuse, then my opponent's probably like nerfing their turn. This effect seems very similar to Oldham's Pitch and Ice defense reaction effect in that they're either going to discard a card with the other effect or they're going to pay two. And in this case, they are either going to, you know, like put a card from the top. Well, they're just going to straight up put a card from the top of the deck. That's what I'm trying to get at. So those are the Elemental Guardian. Now, these are the Guardian effects. We did get a Tear Asunder, which is pretty cool. I don't know if we'll actually get to play this off. It depends on how much, you know, aggression is directed at us in like early turns. If we just go defensive, and we may. I don't foresee us being super aggressive. I foresee us just kind of like defending and slowly dying and trying to make Frostbite tokens for fun. I don't know. We'll see. It's going to be fun though. This card's insane. Tear Asunder is really good. And then we run four Thumps. Thump is also insane. This is the aggressive portion of our deck, is these Thumps and a few of those red attacks right there. Thump getting any buff off of like Cracker Jacks, like I said earlier, makes the Dominate effect go off, and so you can play Cracker Jacks if we want to. Then the Icy Ice Cards. Ice Cards, this is like a huge portion of our deck. We have Icy Encounter. I do run the red one. I only run one red one because I only pulled one red one. I would probably run two because this is a nice little solid threat on the back end. Every card that's blue in this stack, we want to really, 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 really consider keeping in our hand or pitching away when we get it to attack with Winter's Wail, because Winter's Wail is an incremental value weapon. The more you attack with it and threaten ice triggers off of it by pitching these blue ice cards away, the more value we can get long term. So these two blue Icy Encounters are fantastic for that. We run two blue Winter's Grasps as well for the same reason, and because they block for three. The Ice Quake feels a little weird in here. We have one Ice Quake yellow, one red, one blue. These feel a little bit weird because they are just straight up buffs and they can trigger off of your thumps. So if we have an early game hand where we get one of these and we can like pitch away two blues, play Ice Quake, and then jam down a thump, we could be profiting very highly. But outside of that, they block poorly and they're not super great. We have a Weavice yellow and a Weavice blue. I may swap one of these out. I don't know, maybe the yellow. I may swap them. I may just keep them both in because, again, they hit on thump. These Polar Blasts, I recently took out two of the Emerging Avalanche blues and swapped in Polar Blast blues just because they can pitch and trigger our Winter's Wail weapon. You can also play them and Arsenal them. They draw you a card if you play it from Arsenal. So it does actually make some sense to play those down. And then we have just a bunch of like other disruption. We have Winter's Bite, Winter's Bite, Winter's Bite, Winter's Bite, and Winter's Bite. And then a Chill to the Bone. Winter's Bite, by the way, fantastic little card. It forces your opponent to discard a card or pay resources. So basically you're forcing your opponent to do the Oldham effect or the Biting Gale effect. And then finally we have Earth Cards. I put this card in the Earth Card stack. Pulse of Eisenloft technically is a defense reaction that can block for six, but it's also fantastic for fusing. You could also Ice, Earth, and Elemental buff like your defense, so that's kind of nice. Really, really good card. Like I said, we literally opened almost all almost all Oldham stuff. We have one red Autumn's Touch. We have two blue Autumn's Touches, which can attack for five. They can block for three. This one attacking for seven is just straight up scary. And then we have some So Tomorrows. These So Tomorrows are in there for a couple of reasons. One, the only cards we care about fusing Earth for, it's literally one card. Are you ready? It's literally Oak and Old. The only time we'd ever fuse Earth is with Oak and Old. So our Earth does not have to be very extensive, but I did choose to run two So Tomorrows, even though they block two, because they can go fetch the best card in the deck, and that's Endless Winter. They can go get Endless Winter because it is an elemental action card. As you can see here, it's an elemental card, and as you can see here, it is an elemental card. So they can go fetch Endless Winter. So if we end up, you know, early game playing or pitching Endless Winter, sorry, just discarding Endless Winter through a block, we can go fetch that later in the game by playing So Tomorrow. Plus, if you play it from Arsenal, it draws you a card, and it maintains sort of a five-card hand scenario. So it allows you to do some tricky things, and it allows you to kind of meet that fuse requirement that we don't care too much about as far as Earth is concerned. but I do want to keep in consideration. So that's the deck that I'm going to run literally this evening. Literally tonight I'm going to run this deck. Maybe a few changes last minute if I just chicken out on a few things, but this is the goal of the deck. We're going to play Oldham. We're going to try to avoid taking a bunch of damage if we can, and if we can't, we're just going to have a good time making Frostbite tokens. This is kind of what I would do if I were building a Blitz deck for Control Ice Oldham. I'd grab Winter's Wail, I'd find a bunch of nice blue pitch ice cards, and then I would add some threats. So this is very similar to what I would do in an actual Blitz scenario. I would play more towards the ice side of things if I wanted to play ice control. I'd swap out the equipment, of course, for more powerful equipment, but this is basically what I'd be going for. If you guys think that it's gonna go well, leave me a like and a subscribe. If you think it's gonna go very poorly for me, let me know in a comment below. I'd love to hear your feedback. If you think I should swap something out, let me know what I should swap out, like literally in the next few hours. Like, get on the comment section and immediately comment and tell me like what I should swap out. And maybe I have that card pulled in the box, because remember, I have to stick to what I opened in the box, but we'll find out. We'll find out how it goes this evening. Hope you guys enjoyed this. If you want to come watch the stream, I highly, highly recommend that you do. It's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to reminisce about Flesh and Blood. We're going to throw attacks at each other. It's going to be a good time. As always, everybody, thanks for watching.